Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Sukwa and I'm going to share with you 8 big ideas to spice up your online meeting. And over these 3 years since the COVID-19 pandemic, I believe many of us has been used to Zoom meetings, Microsoft Teams meetings, and etc. Thus, many of us may have this fatigue. So, especially if you are the organizer of any online meetings, this is some of the ideas that can help you. Before I start, I'll just like to put a simple disclaimer that the video is produced purely by myself and does not represent any clubs or organizations, because this video can be an inspiration for Toastmasters members. So please discuss with your stakeholders before adopting any of these big ideas. All the best. Most important is remember, just do it and never stop learning. Don't be afraid to share a new idea to your peers. First big idea, creative meeting teams. Why creativity is very important? Because this not only can spark new energy in your meeting, but I think whatever meeting theme that you set, whether it is a festive meeting, a movie meeting, or a futuristic funny kind of meeting, how you want to really bring up the value of the team. So how you can do it at the beginning of the meeting, perhaps you would like to allocate some time to invite your guests and members to go for a round robin to share on the theme. For example, if your theme is related to Christmas, you may want them to share in a very short period of time, like 30 seconds, to share with them, ask them to share what would they normally do during Christmas. And the ball gets rolling. Or if you have a smaller group or a bigger group, depending on what kind of things that you want to talk about. If you are sharing on zero waste day, maybe you want to go into breakout rooms, like 4 person in the breakout room, so that everyone get a chance to speak. Give them a topic, and among few of them, they can share about what they think about the theme or the question. So there we can have a knowledge sharing session, which is a really good warm up as well. So this breakout room, I would suggest if you want to do it, maybe do it in the middle of the meeting, because if suddenly you have a first time visiting guest, it may be quite intimidating for them to be asked to speak at the beginning of the meeting when they are just expecting to observe the meeting conduct. Last but not least, maybe you want to dress up according to the themes. For example, if it's Christmas, you may have a red, green kind of attire. Or maybe if you have a 70s meeting disco party, you want to dress according to the theme as well. And that would be very interesting. And if it appears in a photo, it will look really, really attractive. Okay? Moving on. If you see the two caption on top, educational and entertaining, if there are two ticks, which means this idea has the two elements. Okay. Second big idea, special short sessions. Nowadays, some people find it very difficult to sit through the 2 hours meeting. So I have observed that recently there are a lot of special short sessions, which means there are shorter meetings, or they may include some other additional sessions in a regular Toastmasters meeting. For example, they will invite an invocation speaker to speak and inspire the audience, a humor master to warm up the audience, a leadership talk by a leader, member sharing. For example, maybe you want to invite a new member who just joined, why they come to the club, what they are expecting, etc. Or maybe an experienced member sharing on certain experience, for example, in recruiting members, or how they could advance further in becoming a better speaker. Last but not least, industry expert here refers to this kind of experts. It may or may not share topics related to public speaking or personal development, but it's a new knowledge sharing especially if that person is from that particular club member. For example, maybe it's relating to how to file your tax. It may be related to how to manage your finance, or even how to care for the environment, or how to develop a self-sustaining lifestyle, etc. So all these short sessions can be a meeting highlight, which potentially able to attract a lot of non-Toastmaster guests to your club meeting if you're doing a member recruitment or you are just wanting more people to learn from everyone. Moving up next, the third part is related to videos and music. Who doesn't like videos and music? I believe every one of us, it's like either you like to listen to music or you love to watch video, especially YouTube videos nowadays. So these are chances for you to use it and hype up your meeting. So for example, I saw some clubs, online clubs, they have a very dedicated role player. Sometimes they call it a Zoom master. Sometimes they call it the music master to help navigate the background music. So this person, we need to share the sound all the time. After each speaker has finished speaking, they will put an applause effect or the cheering sound effect, which can be easily downloaded online. And sometimes background music can also be used depending on the theme or what kind of atmosphere you want to generate. In the beginning of the meeting, when guests are slowly coming in, you don't want the situation to sound too quiet. Okay, this online meeting, all right? Or maybe during the break time, you just want to share a song, etc. Depending on your creativity. Of course, there are also instances where if you have a longer break and you're not sure what to do, you can always share educational videos from Toastmasters website or the YouTube channel. Or even I can suggest any personal development related topic website, you can check them out. But of course, you need to review the content before you share it, ensure that it's not too long. And of course, the technical part, whenever you share the video, it's really visible and smooth for everyone to view as well. Because I understand that various country or location, they may be different bandwidth. So not everyone may have a smooth experience in watching the video. So sometimes you may want to consider to just share that video link in the chat box or in other platforms after you play it in the club meeting as well. So here, other than Toastmasters video, maybe you can also have some TEDx video, because TEDx speakers, they always have very niche topic, very interesting one as well. How I normally pick is I will type the keywords and choose the highest views videos. That's the simplest way to choose. The bottom part, this example, is some of those music that I always play, which I chose from YouTube as well. It's so convenient. You can just add all those favorite music, especially royalty-free music, into a playlist in your YouTube channel. So that's easier for you to retrieve every time, and you do not need to type in the search box again to get those music. Why I encourage royalty-free music? Because in case you are going live on Facebook, or you are posting your videos later on in other platforms, this can avoid any copyright issue that may render your video to be taken down, all right? Next part, big idea number four, tweaking the meeting format and agenda. For Toastmasters Club meeting, we know that there are the three standard meeting sessions: table topics or impromptu speaking, prepared speeches session based on the pathways, manual, and lastly, the evaluation session, a very important highlight to give feedback to the speakers as well. So depending on your members' needs, because nowadays you may have fully online meetings or you may have hybrid meetings. So it's very important to maintain the meeting quality by constantly innovating and enable your members to enjoy each meeting. So if your club is facing issues to get members or even guests to attend your meetings, I would strongly suggest try to avoid canceling regular meetings, which normally club meets twice a month. Some club meet four times a month. So other ideas that I can suggest over here is if you have no members want to deliver prepared speech because they are so busy to look at the manuals and prepare their speeches accordingly, maybe I could suggest the following. First, you can get a debate master to host a debate session. If you need some debate questions, you can simply Google up those related topics, which you can just quickly choose it to host the debate session. And the next one, perhaps you can just have a short and sweet meetings. Maybe you can get members to gather together, even 5 or 6, it's fine, and talk about a team, or maybe just to get together and talk about, hey, how is things going? Or if you have a team, breakout room, just make a small discussion to share opinions, learn how to navigate that small group discussion, or even just have a table topics in that 1 hour. Okay. An educational workshop. You may invite one speaker to come and share on certain topics, for example, how to craft your speech, how to project your voice, etc. Okay. Now, this one, the next part is if you only have one prepared speech speaker and you would like to add more value in terms of evaluation, you can always have open evaluation, which means you invite all other audience in the room to share their feedback on the speaker. And sometimes this open evaluation does not only limit them to only the speaker, but also the meeting role players. Multiple evaluators to one speaker, this is what I learned from advanced clubs, because the speaker in particular will have multiple evaluators, which focuses on various areas. For example, first evaluator focus on the content, second evaluator on the vocal variety, and the third maybe on the body language expressions. So it really depends on how you want to add value for your members. The next one is regarding the Speakathon and Table Topics Marathon. Speakathon is very common, especially if the club is newly chartered or you have a surge in new members where many of them you want to encourage them to deliver their speeches. Strike the iron while it's hot. Table Topics Marathon, if there are lack of speakers, you can conduct this because these can enable more members to have a chance to speak and get evaluated. If the group is very small, you can even go 2 rounds of table topics for them. Last but not least is mini speech contest. This mini speech contest is quite different from the normal Toastmasters speech contest because this may not require a formal team of judges. It can be from your audience. You just launch a simple poll to choose the best speaker. And of course, you may want to have a more enticing rewards to entice the participants to deliver their best in this speech contest. All right. Idea number 5, fun table topic session. If you have not checked out my 2 videos regarding the 12 creative ways of table topics, do check them out as well. So, why is table topics very important? Because this is also where it's an opportunity for your guests who are visiting your club for the first time to experience public speaking. So you need to make sure whoever is the table topics master, they are clear in what they are doing. They are clear of what is the result or outcome. So we need some rehearsal as well if you are doing something different. Use of visual aids and props. Make sure that your session is somehow related to your meeting theme and it makes sense. Avoid too complicated instructions. I've once seen a table topics master. They asked the speaker to pick a number and then pick a second number, and the 2 numbers contain words, different words, and when the 2 words combine together, then only the actual topic appears. So by the time they ask the speaker to pick on the necessary items, I think at least 1 minute gone by, and you know what, the speaker can't even remember the whole topic because it needs to go through a certain process to arrive to the final topic. So avoid that, especially online. It will make things complicated. And lastly, Like I said, if you have simple, straightforward instructions, you will be able to give more people to speak in that particular session. Okay. So some other ideas, maybe I can just quickly share with you. You can use music or songs or whatever, sound, audio as your topic. And you can use pictures only, or you want to double up, make it more difficult to ask them, hey, your topic, you need to include the word tiger and fever. And it needs to be related to this picture. So it's something like a storytelling style. And of course, this one is like a debate session or maybe role play, a conversation between two person. And last but not least, this is especially able to do in a physical meeting if you have, where you put in different items in a bag where they choose that particular item, they need to share something about that item. Or maybe you want to just have them pick their own topic. For example, you stick that question on a piece on that item, and that item, they can bring it back as a gift. So the topic is pasted on that item or gift itself. So it's, yeah, everyone gets something in the end, maybe a chocolate or something after they speak. All right. Moving up next is quiz session. This requires some additional preparation because you need to come up with the questions, answers, and test out. So this, I would say it needs some effort, but nowadays there are a lot of question bank online. So you can just Google it up based on what are your interests. For example, it can be a general knowledge quiz. It can be a Toastmasters related quiz or anything at all. All right. What are the platforms that you can use? Mentimeter, Kahoot, Slido, Zoom Poll, PowerPoint, or Canva? Personally, I would suggest PowerPoint. It's a bit manual in a sense, but then you are able to insert animation and arrange how you want them to appear, okay? And of course, Canva, especially if you are on pro version, there are many, many templates for you to choose from. I especially like when there is, you just type quiz. There are some simple templates that pops up. I love those design because they are catered more for the students group. But I think generally it's still suitable for adult as well, depending on what kind of meeting team you have. So I remember that time when I created a quiz deck that can last for 10 to 15 minutes. So 10 to 15 minutes, I would say maybe it's about 15 questions to 20 questions, depending on how much time you have, okay, and how difficult or easy your question is. Sometimes it can be an open-ended question, and sometimes it can be a multiple choice question. So yeah, like I said, the last point, you can insert animation or music to make it more vibrant. Okay, for example, you can also open up the background music and present your PowerPoint at the same time. So whenever you share, people can listen some, you know, vibrant music at the back end, make them feel more excited to share their answer as well. Okay, so why Mentimeter and Kahoot are popular or even Slido is because they have this leaderboard function, okay, here, where this one is, if you are really looking at a serious quiz session where you have some monetary or physical rewards, you may want to use this technique, but just bear in mind that certain charges may apply because you need a pro version to be able to have more than certain number of questions. If not mistaken, Mentimeter is 5. Kahoot, I'm not so sure. Slido is a 3 questions maximum. Okay. So yeah. And Zoom poll is just a general quiz and you won't be able to gauge like who answer which questions correctly or incorrectly. Now, moving on, the last two big ideas is for the games session. Games, I think this one, there are also many ways for you to do it because you can simply Google online. You need to determine why are you doing this? Because at the end of the day, for example, in a Toastmasters meeting, we want to make all the sessions educational as well. And I put a dash over here because most of the time, games does not really, really have 100% educational value, because sometimes it's really, really just for fun. So here, warm up, intermission, or just for fun, depending on your time, because we don't want to like you play the game until it costs your whole agenda to be delayed. Consider your logistics time available and rehearse if necessary. Like I said earlier in the table topics as well, if you need to conduct a games, you need to do a short rehearsal or even discuss with someone else, you know, to back you up in case things go wrong. Or maybe you need to do a short demo before you conduct the actual game so that everyone understands the instructions, and when you play it, it will get excited, okay? Put yourself in your audience shoes, and most importantly, when you conduct the games, you need to sound a little bit more excited. Raise your energy level, hype it up, okay? Especially online meeting. People only can really engage with you through your voice, and maybe if you want to have some music to make it more interesting. So if you want to Google for those ideas, you can check out team building, virtual meeting, energizers for online meeting, etc. So some of those screenshots that I have over here are like brain teasers, give me five, find the hidden pictures, first letter game, last letter game, which requires a lot of brain juice, guessing games, tongue twisters, you get everyone to speak, visual puzzles, finding things as well. Okay, so of course, there is also warm-up session, really, really like an exercise where you can ask everyone to do it together with you at their desk. Okay, this is like a really physical warm-up. So here, there are also ideas on a virtual scavenger hunt, which I have played before as well, which means the participants will need to go and quickly grab that thing in their room. Okay, who is the last one will lose, or who is the first one will win the game. Okay, there are also the online team building bingo for you to explore as well. Last but not least, thank you very much for staying tuned until right now. Celebration. Celebration and achievement is very important to recognize a person's effort and motivating them to go further in their journey. So, for example, in Toastmasters Club, what we can do is we can celebrate members' achievements whenever they complete certain levels. There are five different levels. Whenever they have a new milestone in life, for example, one of your members have a newborn baby, or maybe they recently get engaged, or they have a promotion, etc. So we can always have these kind of celebrations. Either you want to do it in your own group, your chat group, or you can have a special event. Okay, or maybe it can be part of your regular meeting. You want to do this like twice in a quarter, or maybe twice in a term, depending. But I think it's really important to start doing this celebration. And of course, it needs some planning as well. So I have also seen clubs where their club member has connections with artists. They actually let the members or even those artists to showcase their talent, singing, dancing, or other artistic performance online, ladies and gentlemen. So this can be a special highlight. For example, if that person is really famous or a social media influencer, it can be an opportunity to invite guests to join your club event and become an open house meeting. Okay, so consider to do joint celebration as well if needed, because when more people comes together, the more the merrier, and it's easier to do things as well. So thank you very much for listening to me for the 8 big ideas. I hope you learned something from this video. If you have any comments for me, which of these 8 big ideas you think is most useful for you to be implemented, do share with me below. Or if you would like to have any other questions for me, you can also personally reach out to me. Do subscribe and also click the bell notification for more new videos relating to personal development and of course Toastmasters. Thank you for watching. Bye.